What's up everybody, welcome back, and today I am recording with my new webcam, Logitech C922. I guess the footage is very clear now, and some of you have been telling me that the video quality was not very good, but now I guess that complaint is not going to be there anymore. The videos are great with this webcam and it's quite cheap also. Therefore, today's topic is on Punarvasu Nakshatra, the person, the man, the main man, after whom today's festival is known. Who is he? He is Lord Ram himself. Dussehra, the festival of joy, lights, wisdom and victory is celebrated today in India. Well, we all know about what Dussehra is, right? We know that this was the day when Lord Ram had extinguished finally the entire race of the Rakshasas in Lanka, including Ravan, Kumkaran, Meghnath, Prahast, Atikai, so many, my god, Akampan, Devantak, Nalantak, Akshay, so many, Kumbh, Nikumbh, the sons of Kumkaran, and finally it ended in the defeat of the great Ravana. Well, Ravana was the son of, you are right, Vishrava and Kaikasi. Now see, Ravana's grandfather had a very beautiful plan. Ravana's grandfather, his mother's father, he had a very wonderful plan. He thought, what is the use of marrying my daughter to another Rakshas, a demon, because Vishnu is anyways going to come and kill them. Yes. So if I have to get a grandson who is invincible, then I will combine the power of the Brahmins and I will combine the power of the demons. Okay. Because then what happens? Brahmanas have intelligence and demons have power, physical power, and ability to do things. And then when these two will mix, the product will be very strong, will be invincible. Nobody will be able to defeat him. That was his thought, Ravana's grandfather's thought. And with this sinful idea in mind, he went to the great sage Pulastya, who is directly Lord Brahma's son himself. And he told that, I want to hand over my daughter to your son Vishrava. And then Pulastya Muni agreed to it. And then finally Vishrava married Kaikasi. And then by their union, Ravan was born. And Ravan had different names. Ravana's first name was Dashanan. Dashanan means one who has 10 heads, because he had so much intelligence, because he was the product of Brahmans, Brahminical intelligence and demoniac power from his mother and from his father. Because of that, he had so much intelligence that it could not be contained in one head. That is why he had to have 10 heads to keep it. And that is why his name was Dashanan in the beginning. But then he went to please Lord Shiva, and then Lord Shiva gave him the name Ravan. Ravan means one who makes everybody cry. Rudand. From the word Rudand comes the word Rudra. And by his invincible powers, he had gone on a rampage. See, Ravana's mentality is like that of a person who has entered a supermarket. What happens when you enter a supermarket? You just want to take anything you want. You go with the aim of getting something, but then you pick up something else, right? But Ravana's case was, he just wanted everything for himself. He used to think the whole world is a supermarket which is meant for his enjoyment. That is what Ravana used to think. And because of that, he had gone and done so many wrong activities which are not to be done by good people. which are immoral, which are prohibited by the scriptures. And because of those things, he had terrible curses above him. Some say he had 12 curses, some say he had 18 curses. But even if it is 12, how does it matter? It's a big number, right? And because of all these curses, ultimately he ended up in his destruction. Well, in India, there are so many messages being flooded in WhatsApp. Let's destroy Ravana's 10 heads internally. Let's do this, let's do that. I am not going to give a standard interpretation here. Ravana's most important characteristic is what? What is the one characteristic which makes him Ravana? It is his belief on himself that he is superior to God. Because when the war was going on, when Kumkaran woke up, Kumkaran was his brother, and Kumkaran said to him, "You have done so many activities, I never stopped you, but the activity which you have done today, kidnapping Sita, that is going to cost you your entire life, and the entire dynasty is going to be ruined because of that." And then Ravana said to him, "Oh, if you don't want to fight on my behalf, go and sleep. I don't want you." That means even Kumbhakaran, his brother, knew that destruction is at hand if you fight against Lord Ram, because he is not different from Vishnu himself. And who can fight against God? Nobody. But Ravana had this belief that he can not only fight, he can not only terrorize Ram by taking his wife away, but he can also defeat and kill him. That's the foolishness which he had. And that is why that quality is known as Ahankar. Because when the demigods, including Indra, Varuna, Chandra, Surya, approached Lord Brahma, then Lord Brahma along with them went to Lord Vishnu. And then they requested him that, "Please help us from the demon Ravana. Please kill him or do whatever you feel is just." And then he decided, Lord Vishnu said, "I will take an incarnation. I will take birth as the son of Dasharatha and Kaushalya. And then I will slay this demon Ravana." And there Lord Vishnu says something very instructive. He says, "The destruction of an egoistic person is," he says, "the seed of destruction of an egoistic person is hidden inside the ego of the person." Should I repeat? "The seed of destruction of an egoistic person is hidden inside the seed of the person's ego." It is hidden inside the ego itself. What do you mean by this? When Ravana was asking boons to Lord Brahma, that, "Oh, I should be invincible from this, from that, he should not kill me, he should not be able to kill me, he also should not be able to kill me, nobody should be able to kill me." He had a long list from Brahma and Shiva by which he became almost invincible. But Ravana said to Lord Brahma that, "Please do not give me the blessing that humans and monkeys cannot kill me, because it is an embarrassment for me." Because it is to be understood that if somebody is invincible with the demigods, like Indra, head of the demigods, the devatas, the suras, it is obvious that humans and vanaras, which are known as the monkeys, I mean, they are not monkeys, but to be loosely translated, how can humans and monkeys defeat me? It is impossible, right? And because of that, Lord Brahma said, "Okay, I do not give you protection from humans and monkeys." And that is why Lord Ram took birth, I mean Lord Vishnu took incarnation as a human. Because that would qualify Lord Brahma's benediction simultaneously, and he would also die. So there you see, if only Ravana would have not asked this stupid clause of not giving protection, because he had this ego. And as Lord Vishnu said, the seed of destruction is itself in the ego. Which means that because he used to think that he is so great that humans and monkeys cannot kill him, then he asked this boon. And then what happened? The entire dynasty was slain. It's complete. The place Lanka became a smashan. It became like a graveyard. There was nobody living there. Only one person lived. He was Vibhishan, Ravana's brother. And that too, he only lived because he was on the side of Lord Ram. Otherwise, he would have also been killed. Nobody else survived. Atikai was his other son from his next wife, Dhanyamalini. He was also dead. Indrajit, his most cherished, most valored, and most loved eldest of his sons, for whom he arranged to make a perfect horoscope. Can you imagine? For Indrajit, Ravana had arranged to make a perfect horoscope because Ravana had already captured the Navagrahas, the nine planets. And he wanted to put all the planets in the 11th house, which is the house of gains. And that is why he was invincible. But later on, there was another kind of a planet which was created by Saturn and Jupiter, which is known as Gulika or Mandi in the south. And that is referred to as poison. And then Mandi sat there and the 11th house was destroyed, because of which Indrajit died later on. But the point I am saying that Ravana had this belief that he can even challenge God. He can even kill God. He can even destroy God. Can you imagine? And who is Ravana actually? Ravana actually is the tendency of Rahu inside. Because Rahu says, I can do anything, whatever I want. I can even wipe out God also if I want. I can do that. Well, that's foolishness. And if you do that, then there will be a Ram who will be born and he will slaughter you off. So that is why I would request everybody that we keep our ego in control and we be realistic and we try to follow the word of Lord Ram rather than challenging him. Because whoever was on the side of Lord Ram, they lived. Even in the case of Kurukshetra, whoever was siding on the side of the Pandavas, they were victorious. Why they were victorious? Because Lord Krishna was on their side, not because that they were more powerful than the Kauravas. In fact, Kauravas had 11 Akshohini divisions and the Pandavas had only 7. So now you see, numbers, they say na, numbers matter, but there you see what happened. Because Krishna was there, the numbers didn't matter. And similarly, on the side of Lord Ram also. What do the monkeys of Sugriv's army, what kind of fighting do they know? They don't know much. But Ravana's army, my God, it was the perfect skilled army. Perfect in every kind of warfare. Starting from swords to arrows to divine celestial weapons. But then, even then, they perished. Because they were on the side of adharma, on the side of wrong, on the side of evil, on the side of injustice. So the takeaway point from Dussehra is, instead of challenging God all the time, which many people these days do, we should try to follow on his path. Whatever Lord Ram said, we should try to do that. Maintain a life of principles, maintain a life of goodness, maintain a life. Even Lord Ram himself used to worship Lord Vishnu. It is like saying he is worshipping himself. But when he was doing that, he was acting as a human. Because that is why he is known as Maryada Purushottam. And then he showed everybody the way that you should also worship God. Whichever religion you are, whichever sect you are, whichever tradition you are connected to, whichever parampara you are following, please try to follow that. That is what I want to say on the occasion of Dussehra. And if you continue doing it, what will happen? This monstrous demon, this enemy inside us, which is Rahu. What is Rahu? Rahu is basically doubts. That okay, maybe this process works, maybe this process doesn't work. all those doubts will perish one day. And then the Ravana inside us will be killed by Lord Ram. Remember, only one person can kill Ravana, nobody else. Nobody can even dream of challenging him, what to speak of killing him. It is next to impossible. It's impossible to the highest degree that you can kill Ravana yourself. If you think you can kill Ravana yourself, you are so wrong. You can't do it. Only Lord Ram can do. And if you talk of propensities, what does Ravana represent inside? Ravana is the significator of lust, the desire to enjoy something which does not belong to us. Sita Devi was not his wife. He already had so many wives. The most beautiful of all ladies, Mandodari, was his wife. But still, his lust, his desire for getting things which do not belong to him, he was obsessed by that. And that is why he had also approached Vedvati, who was doing penance to get Lord Vishnu as her husband. But he broke Vedvati's penance, and then Vedvati cursed that, "I will come and destroy you." So there you see, if you let this enemy of lust go on a rampage like Ravana did, then our fate will also be like Ravana, which we do not want, right? That is why you will see big leaders, presidents, prime ministers of big nations falling prey to lust. And imagine how precarious their state is if that happens. Very sorry state, right? Therefore, to fight this enemy of lust which is within us, we need the help of Lord Ram. And today is the best day, the best day to pray for him. Because when we pray, then he will also shoot the arrow which is known as Ramban. And that will pierce the heart and enter where Ravana is sitting inside. And that will knock him off completely. How much ever strong he is, it doesn't matter. Okay? That is it from my side. If you have any questions, queries, then let me know. And like and comment and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, until next Dussehra, bye-bye. See you.